Hello everyone, I've got a Christmas themed sequence for you today, and it says 1, 3, 6, 10, and so on. Now, why is this a Christmas themed sequence? That's because this is the number of gifts you get on each day of the song, The 12 Days of Christmas. So on the first day of Christmas, you get a partridge in a pear tree. On the second day of Christmas, you get two turtle doves and a partridge in a pear tree. You get three gifts altogether. On the third day of Christmas, you get three French hens, two turtle doves, and a partridge in a pear tree. You get six gifts altogether on the third day. And so, why your true love is so obsessed with birds, we don't know. But how many gifts do you get on the 12th day of Christmas? Now, these are called triangle numbers. That's because you can write them as a triangle. So, in this case, this would be the fourth triangle number. So, it would be four calling birds, three French hens, two turtle doves, and a partridge in a pear tree, and you get 10 gifts altogether. Now, if I want to work out how many gifts I get on the 12th day, I could write out a triangle like this and add up all the rows, but there is a smarter way to do this. I'm going to write this triangle in a slightly different way. This is the fourth triangle number again, just slightly different. Now, I'm going to make two copies of this, so it looks like this. I'm going to take one of the copies, I could turn it around, I'm going to put them together. And I end up making a rectangle that has four rows and five columns. So altogether, I've got 20 dots here, but I only want half of them. So then I divide by two, and that's my fourth triangle number. Now, you can do this in general. So if you want to work out the nth triangle number, what you do is you make a rectangle with n rows, n plus one columns, and then you divide by two, and that's the nth triangle number. Now, on the 12th day of Christmas, you want to work out the 12th triangle number, which means it's 12 times 13, divide by 2, and you get 78 gifts, which sounds like my sort of lady to me. Now, fresh from your success of Christmas and working out how triangle numbers work, you decide to go to a New Year's Eve party. Now, there are 50 other people at this party, so there are 51 guests altogether, if you include yourself. How many handshakes will there be at this party? Well, let's do this again. Let's try five people here. So we've got to call them a name. Alice, Bob, Catherine, Dave, name beginning with E, Eric. Now, Alice doesn't shake hands with herself, but she does shake hands with Bob, Catherine, Dave, and Eric. Now, Bob here has already shaken hands with Alice, doesn't need to do it again, doesn't shake hands with himself, and he does shake hands with the other three guests. If you look here, what I get is the fourth triangle number. Now, take a note of that. There are five guests, and this is the fourth triangle number. That's the number of handshakes there were at the party. So if I have 51 guests, I need to work out the 50th triangle number, which is 1,275. But this is something you can do for any party. So how many handshakes would there be at a party with 101 guests and so on? So who said maths wasn't Christmassy? And if you have been, thanks for watching.